Hi guys. Today I want us to talk about leadership behavior. And again, the temptation is to think about them. I want you to think about yourself. Any one of you who is in a leadership role, always remember that you're the most visible person throughout your team or throughout your organization. Every day, everybody is watching you, what you say and what you do. And when there's an inconsistency between what you say and what you do, people will watch. Others may call you up on it, but others in silence will watch and make conclusions. And slowly your credibility as a leader starts to be eroded. The key question is, if our staff in corporates had to vote for us, how many of us would survive? If our staff had to give honest feedback about our behavior, how many of them would say wonderful things about us? Because the reality is that many of us as leaders have become bullies. We make people's lives miserable. The way we shout, the way we humiliate, the way we denigrate people. We do all of these things in the name of power, in the name of authority, in the name of being able to execute. Remember, leadership is not a title held. It's an influence felt. It's more important that that influence is a positive influence. Because all of us as leaders, we cast a shadow over the teams and the organizations we lead. If that shadow is a dark shadow, that organization is shaped by that dark shadow. If you allow bullying, if you allow sexism, if you allow tribalism, if you allow ethnic focus in your team, all of those things will really shape the character of your team. So as a leader, you have to deeply introspect. How do I show up as a leader? How do I behave as a leader? How do I treat people as a leader? It's important that you treat all of your staff with dignity and respect, regardless of their station in life, regardless of the positions that they occupy in life. You know, when I travel the length and breadth of this continent, there are people I meet. Some of them may be a security guard. Some of them may be a messenger. Some of them may be a receptionist or a teller. All of them know me. I may not know them. The question is, when they see me, what do I project? What image do they have of me? When they go back to talk about me to their families, what stories do they tell? I can't think that only when I meet them and I'm now having an official conversation, I now put a corporate mask and I try to be nice to everybody. But all the time, I'm brutal, I'm cruel, and I'm evil to staff. Hear me well. I'm not saying at any moment that there are no times where you have to be direct and give feedback to your staff. But the way you do it, you must never take people's dignity away. I always believe our job as leaders is to reprimand privately and celebrate publicly. In that way, we're teaching in every moment that we have. Every encounter we have with our staff is an opportunity to listen, to learn, to share ideas. I get a lot of my insights from just listening to people, talking to them. But I cannot talk to them if the environment doesn't allow for that. So I ask all of us as leaders, here's your challenge. I challenge you to lead from the front with a flag rather than behind with a whip. In that way, you'll really create an environment of passion, excitement, and success for all of your staff. Always remember, you yourself were led one day. What are the things you hated from your line manager or from your boss? Why is it that now you're in a leadership position, you are doing exactly the very things that you hated? Treat everybody the way you would like to be treated. If we did that, our staff will come to work with a bright smile, and they will deliver amazing service. They'll deliver amazing results. As I always say, the front line is your bottom line. How you treat your staff is how they will treat your customers. And that is a message for all of us. Let's watch those behaviors. Let's get that feedback and really lead with inspiration.